Behind you is this huge window that I want to use to create. What's up everybody, welcome back to a new video. My name is Rens, I'm a freelance digital artist from the Netherlands and I love photo manipulation. And I was thinking, how can I apply photo manipulation to my daily life so that I get stuck with it, so that I can get my imagination running? I was thinking, okay, I have my iPhone 7, I don't really have a good camera yet. But I've got my iPhone. What can I do to this room? So can I create holes in the walls? Can I make things an underwater scene? Whatever I can come up with. So behind you actually, and I will film this with my phone right now. So right over here behind you is this huge window that I want to use to create some really cool underwater world. I'm gonna take a picture right now. And there we go, and I'll show you the picture and then we jump into Affinity Photo and we're just gonna edit something crazy. All right, let's go. All right, so the first thing that I want to do is to cut out the window. So I grab my pen tool and I go over to the window and let's actually make a quick selection so we can mask it out. Alright, so the window is cut out, but you can see that I forgot the tripod, so I want to include the tripod so we have something in front of the window. And let me do that right now. All right, so now we're gonna find some underwater images. So let's just type in underwater on Unsplash and let's see what we can find. This looks pretty cool. So let's just simply drag and drop it in our image and let's drag it to the background. Maybe rotate it a little. I think that looks pretty cool. Now you can see that the rest of the image is way too, not blue, let's say, so let's make the image more blue by going into the back. Let's select the background, go into white balance and just increase the blues a lot. So now you can see it already blends a lot better with the rest of the image. So maybe we can even add some green. Maybe a bit of magenta. And actually what we can do, this works, it works even better, is simply pressing Command J to duplicate the layer and drag it above everything. And now there's the trick. What we can do is blur this image. So we go to filter, we go to blur, and we go to Gaussian blur, and we blur it like a lot so that we only get like, let's say, the color. And what we do now, come on, blur. Thank you. And what we want to do now is simply set the blend mode to color. So now you can see that everything has got this blue tone. And this is the before and this is the after. So this actually does a lot with the whole image already. So now it actually automatically matches the whole surrounding of the image. So looks amazing to me. Let's try to see if we can find some underwater animal. This actually looks really fun, a polar bear, but I was looking or thinking more about a whale or a shark. So let's see if we can find something. And I see that the pictures of whales are more above the surface of the water. And obviously we're gonna need some underwater pictures. So let me try shark, and there we go. There we have an amazing picture of a shark. Let's simply drag it in. And this is gonna work super well with the lighting, as you can see maybe. So let's make a quick selection of the shark. Let's actually reduce the opacity so we can see what we're doing and maybe make it a little smaller, just like so. And yeah, I guess we're gonna grab the pen tool to make the nicest cutout because I want this shark to be super sharp. So let's select it with the pen tool. It's really hard to see the blue line for me, so I cannot really see where my outline is. So let's create a small outline that we can actually see what we're selecting. So this way it's a lot easier to select your subject with the pen tool, especially when the background is blue as well, just like the line of the pen tool. All right, so we are all the way around. Let's hit mask and let's see what our shark looks like. So obviously the colors are not right yet, but if we move it below our layer, you can see that magically the shark already looks like it is in position somehow. I think it's too contrasty. So what I want to do is add a levels adjustment layer and clip it to the shark. And I want to slide the output black level up so that it actually matches better with the background. So let's slide it up until about here. And there's one last thing that I want to do, and that is actually to darken the bottom of the shark a little bit, because now I think it's just too bright and we could make it even more realistic if I would darken the bottom of the shark. So I think we can do this with an exposure adjustment layer and by dragging the level, the values lower actually. And now I want to invert this layer mask, so the layer mask of the exposure adjustment layer, by pressing Command I. And now when I brush in with my, let's say with a black brush, with a white brush, you can actually see that I'm darkening the shark. So maybe I put it a little too dark, but we'll see how it works out. So let's reduce the opacity for now. And just like, let's say gradually, add some shadow to the bottom of the shark. Let's see the before and the after. I'm not really satisfied, so I think I'm gonna go for even lower opacity, and that looks a lot better to me actually.
All right, that was it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed this episode. At least I had a ton of fun manipulating my own aquarium right around here. Of course, there's tons of more things that I could add to this picture or this photo manipulation. However, I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. If you enjoyed this video as well, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you have any suggestions on what I could manipulate next time, please let me know down below in the comments so that I can create what you would love to see. Last thing, if you love Affinity Photo or if you love photo manipulation in general, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll try to release a new video every week, and then I hope to see you in my next video. Ciao!